Welcome to the shop. Today we're going to be building a sonic flame tube with a box of scraps.
A sonic flame tube, often called a Rubens tube after its inventor, is a device mostly used as a fiery acoustics demonstration. When gas enters and is dispersed through a pipe, standing waves are formed as a speaker pumps sound frequencies into a diaphragm, which are then reflected on the opposite side of the tube. Essentially, this creates a flaming oscilloscope. So let's build one! I started with drilling a small pilot hole into a 3-inch PVC end cap. I then widened the hole to 7/16 inches so it can be threaded with a 1/4 inch NPT tap. I really should have used a tap wrench, but hey, gotta work with what you have. This end cap is going to serve as both a reflector and the gas inlet for the flame tube. Then with some Teflon tape, I tightened a hose barb into the freshly tapped hole. The end cap fits snugly into the wider end of a 4-inch to 3-inch duct reducer, and it was then secured with some HVAC foil tape. Then I took a 2-foot-long section of round 3-inch duct and worked a line down it opposite the seam. I marked every 1/2 inch down the line, leaving a 4-inch gap on either end of the duct pipe. At each mark, a 1/16-inch hole was drilled through the duct pipe. I then just used a file to remove any burrs. Some more HVAC foil tape was used to close the seam along the back of the duct pipe. The reducer then fit into the pipe and was taped on with a barb rotated 90 degrees from the holes on top. I then began cutting a 3-inch PVC pipe roughly down the middle with a hacksaw for the base. I wasn't thinking here, and I cut towards my fingers. Never cut towards your fingers. The rough edges were then sanded with some sandpaper. A couple of screws secured the pipe halves and some scrap wood onto a fiberboard base. A cut-up party balloon was stretched around the open end of the pipe and will act as our diaphragm. This was attached with some more HVAC foil tape. The next step is setting up the propane gas handling components. I wrapped Teflon tape around a 3/8 inch by 3/8 inch nipple and screwed it into the propane regulator. And then I used a wrench to help tighten it in place. After wrapping Teflon around the other side of the nipple, it was screwed into a 3/8 inch ball valve and also tightened. Similar process was taken for the 3/8 inch hose barb into the ball valve. Then a hose clamp was slipped over some 3/8 inch clear vinyl tubing and the barb was inserted into the tube. The hose clamp was then screwed in to prevent any leaks. These same steps were repeated for the hose barb sticking out of the end cap. After ensuring that the ball valve was closed, the regulator was then hooked up to the propane tank. Soapy water was sprayed onto all the fittings. The tank's valve was slowly opened as it checked for any bubbles caused by leaks. There were no leaks found, so we were ready to go for a test run. I opened the tank valve and then the ball valve slightly. Now that gas is flowing to the tube, I lit the gas with a barbecue lighter. The flames got pretty high, so I then adjusted the ball valve until I got the flames about 1/2 inch to 1 inch high. Now that I knew the flame part of the flame tube was working, I shut off the gas. I then plugged in an aux cable into the small audio amplifier I had. I then plugged the other end of the aux cable to an adapter and connected it to my keyboard piano. And our sonic flame tube was all ready. I set the piano tone to sine lead and then began to play. It's really cool how the location of the pressure nodes and antinodes change as I play each note.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe for the next video. See you next time.